And in the face of all these lefties suffering from Trump derangement syndrome, this guy gives quite an accurate response.
You can take my ears, but you cannot take my liberty. They want to cut off my ears like the Taliban, but what they don't know is my ears can grow back like SpongeBob through budding, by the way. Hit me with your best shot, why don't you? Because if that's the best you got, you're a loser. You're such a loser, you missed so bigly. By the way, you had a big opportunity. You could have made my head blow up on TV, but you didn't do that, did you? Now my ear is going to grow back bigger and better.
Joining me now is filmmaker and journalist Army Horowitz. Army, good to see you. How good was that compared to all the insane lefty losing it videos we've seen? I mean, the Trump derangement syndrome is at another level right now.
Yeah, it sure is. It's on display across the country. And look, it's terrible to say, but what you're seeing with people across the country on the left is that this assassination attempt wasn't because of the insane amount of rhetoric against President Trump. Really, they're doing it because they're saying, hey, it's your fault, right? I mean, Trump, are the one who has said these things. Therefore, this is what it has led to. Like, there's no self-reflection here. They're looking to blame the victim, right? They're looking to blame Republicans and Trump and their rhetoric for the attack on him. That's what it's come down to. So, look, it's always nice to have a little bit of levity in this very dire and dark time that we have.
Yeah, completely. I just find it bizarre. Some people saying it's staged, it's fake. It's just on a different level right now. Now, Army, let's talk about the catastrophic security failure that led to Donald Trump being shot. The head of the Secret Service, Kimberly Cheatle, a.k.a. Dr. Jill Biden's top pick for the job, is now blaming, get ready for it, a sloped roof for the security failure.
The shooter climbing up seemingly unimpeded, about 400 feet from the stage, with a direct line of sight on the former president.
Should that roof have been secure, period?
That building in particular has a sloped roof at its highest point. And so, you know, there's a safety factor that would be considered there, that we wouldn't want to put somebody up on a sloped roof. And so, you know, the decision was made to secure the building from inside.
Now, the irony in this is that the snipers who were behind Trump during the rally were on a sloped roof as well. There's the image. And here is a picture of an agent standing on the White House roof. And would you look at that? It's sloped as well, Army. I mean, surely it's time to sack Kimberly Cheatle. She clearly has no idea what she's on about.
Yeah, look, a while back, the Secret Service said it was their goal to make it 30% female. I'm not sure exactly why that is. I think their focus should be to make it 100% competent and effective, which it seems like it may not be. I think that might be a bigger problem. And look, I'm not saying women can't do the job, but you have to have women who can do the job, right? You have to have women who can handle a man like Trump, who's 215 pounds, 6'3". I'm not going to convert it to your crazy system because I was told there wasn't going to be any math in this interview. But the point is, he's a large man, and you need somebody who can not only handle him but holster her weapon at the same time. Joe Biden can't fire her. Do you know why? He doesn't know who she is. In a Lester Holt interview, he was asked, and he kept calling her him. Now, unless she changed her pronouns, the president of the United States doesn't know who the head of the Secret Service is. That's going to be a problem when it comes to firing her. And look, beyond that, I think that, you know, when this Lester Holt interview actually was a pretty big deal. It all got kind of washed away in the news of the assassination and the VP pick. But it was quite revealing, particularly when Lester Holt asked him about the rhetoric. Now, when Joe Biden had a chance to bring the temperature down, and he did in a sense, but at the end of the day, what he ended up doing was he kept saying, you have to keep the rhetoric down, instead of saying, I have to do the same thing. And Lester Holt called him out on that and asked him about it. And he didn't say, you're right, I need to do that. He actually doubled down and said, hey, what else, how else do you want me to describe him if not saying he's a threat to democracy? Because that's what he is. He doubled down on this rhetoric even after the assassination. This is where we're at.
It's just insane. It is madness from every single way you look at it. And, you know, you mentioned the women of the Secret Service and the diversity picks clearly on full display over the weekend. But they were like a pack of fumbling fumbleliners. And I think that this particular video sums up their efforts.
After Secret Service Barbie, a highly trained member of the Secret Service, removes her weapon from its holster for the very first time in her career. She struggles to return her pea shooter as though it's her first day on the job. Fortuitously, her skills from a previous life as an amateur actress come into play, allowing her to convincingly mimic the swift draw of the weapon and scan the horizon for threats. Chewing her gum nonchalantly, she attempts to exude a tactical demeanor, reminiscent of a fusion between the Blues Brothers and Rosie O'Donnell.
Look, she couldn't find her holster. Another agent was preoccupied with her sunglasses. They were running around like headless chooks. Meanwhile, the former president had been shot. And what I noticed was at on the first day of the Republican convention when Donald Trump walked in, there were no female security in sight. It was all men. So what does that tell you?
Yeah, look, it goes back to this idea of they have to have some kind of, you know, weird random number on how many women they want to have. Again, I want to make this clear. I'm not saying women can't do the job. I mean, I've seen some pretty badass women out there, and those are the kind of people they should be hiring. But I think Secret Service 101 is learn how to take out your weapon and then reholster it. I think that's kind of like the first thing you're supposed to learn on the job. And just again, just look at the size of her. She just can't handle a man of President Trump's size. I think that's what it comes down to. I think it's ridiculous. Like, I'm not saying that there's any kind of conspiracy here that they weren't trying to give him the best people they could. Look, I remember I spent 10 days with Secret Service people when Ivanka Trump was at a program that I was on, and I got to know these guys really well, and they're phenomenal. They're absolutely great, totally competent. But I'm saying that the people we saw there did not seem to be at the top of their game.